Hi, I'm Kevin Hill, and today we're going to do something that's quite a bit different. We're going to do a little train that's running through our landscape. It should be a lot of fun. Of course, if you're enjoying these, be sure to leave a like and subscribe for more painting videos. All right, let's get started. We'll start today here with our 2-inch brush and some blue and white. Kind of a normal way to start a painting, isn't it? Of course, they got the little bit of clear gel and white at the top. Now, of course, I know you've seen the sketch. It's right down here. And what I did was I just kind of did a slightly rough basic sketch of a train. It's one of those old trains, it's not the newer ones. A steam train, which should be pretty cool. I don't know, I just think that's better for a painting, but you know, you do whatever you want. There we go. And you see the angle on this thing is super foreshortened and it disappears very quickly into a tunnel. There's a lot of depth to it, which I think is kind of cool. I think it's probably good. So we'll talk a lot more about the train as we do it. I've never done one before, so. It's just kind of going to be a first for both of us, I guess, unless you guys have done one. There. It should be a lot of fun. I can't see any big problems happening. I think it'll just be a fun experience. Now I'm just going to block in these mountains. You see, I just took a couple seconds and did a sketch, a much easier sketch than the one of the train, I will say. So this way we're set up for a little bit of success with our mountains. See, I'm doing it with a worn out detail round brush because A, it's worn out. I don't want you to do this with a good one. And because it'll destroy the brush too quickly, scrubbing like this. You know, be more gentle with this brush. And secondly, because I want to get all these little tiny bits of light and dark. If you did this with a filbert, although it would work and it would be about 3 times as fast, you would lose all your subtleties in here. Subtle variation of color. And I think that's going to be necessary to this painting. I really do, or I wouldn't bother. You know me, I don't like to spend a whole lot of time up here that I don't need to. There, so I really do believe it's going to help us. That's it. We'll put some snow and stuff on this, but for now, that's probably good enough. Now, before we go too far, I'm going to start painting in our train. Number one, I want to be able to put my hands down here. I'm trying not to get into the rock sketch down there, but I want to just make sure that I can have something to steady my hand with. And I'm tight. I've been thinking, and I'm not sure how this is going to go, but I'll just throw it out there. We may want to do this painting over 2 weeks, maybe make a 2-part series out of this thing, because I don't want to skimp on the details. I've never done this before, and I don't want to kind of do it halfway. And because I haven't practiced this, I'm not sure how wet it's going to get. I did throw a little clear gel in there because I didn't want any scratchy, bumpy lines like you would get if you were painting, because remember, this is all dry, if you're painting with fairly thick oils. So, you know, we'll see. I just don't know. I guess you already know by the title of the video, but I don't. There. So anyway, I'm just going to paint this in. You can see this is my gray mix right here. Just slide over, grab a tiny bit. You don't want much of that, just a little. Maybe a little more black. So my thought, actually the light's coming this way, I better not do that black. So my thought is, at least let's get this thing underpainted and see how much detail we can add. Now I did sand this canvas. I sanded it with some, I think 400 grit sandpaper. And that will help make it smooth, almost like a portrait smooth canvas, which will help us. There. I'm gonna do my best not to lose the detail, but this is not a paint by number. I couldn't do that if I tried. I don't stay in the lines. I'm not that neat of a person, so. Anyway, I'm just gonna work here. I'm just gonna sit and try to fill in these colors as best I can without ruining my sketch too much. And then I'll come right back. And then I'll show you how to add beautiful light detail and all that good stuff. We'll make it fit into the painting with color. It'll be so cool. I think now would be a good time to mention that I am not a train expert. And I'm not trying necessarily to create a crazy realistic train. In fact, I know that all the parts to this train are not here. They're missing. And I'm good with that. I'm not worried. I've got friends who sit down and do pen and ink trains. that are just unreal. Well, that's not me. So, rather than trying to do something that, for somebody like me who's kind of loose, would just drive me absolutely crazy, I'm gonna have fun incorporating a train in the landscape where it's a part of the landscape, but it's not the entire thing. It's important, but it's not everything. There. Not a whole lot of that roof is showing, actually. There. Nice. We can always trim that up. It looks like it needs to be trimmed quite a bit, actually, now that I'm looking at it. So I'll kind of show you how I'm going to do a lot of this. So I put in a little, and then I'll come in here with my feather brush, and I'll trim it. So I got it way too high. So I'll trim it right down. There, that's a bridge right there. Or not a bridge, but actually the entrance to a tunnel. Cool. Perspective is so crazy important in this painting. Ridiculously important. So you gotta make sure you do it reasonably accurate. That's as good as we need to go. It's reasonably accurate. There we go. All right, maybe a little blue and white. Here, let me show you my palette. A little blue and white. And let's do a couple of windows. So too much paint. I don't wanna have a lot of texture on there. There we go. And if we do another day on this, I'll go ahead and let it fully dry. And we can kind of go crazy with the details. There, but I'm just gonna do my best as it is right now. Not bad. Little window. Window in the front as well. There's maybe one on this. Sorry, I'm so quiet. It's just I'm concentrating so much. This is fun. You guys should give new stuff a try. If you haven't done new stuff recently, do something new. I don't care if it's this or anything. Just give something new a try. Nice. Actually, I see that line now. That line comes and then goes out. That's what I was missing. There we go. That's a little better. I still gotta work on that though. Okay, I'll fix this. And I'll also work on some other things. Maybe back here. I think this is their little coal car. So we'll put a little paint on this too. One last quick little touch here before I go on to something else. Just want to throw in the lens here. A little glass thing that the light is behind. Good, okay, good, that's it. Now obviously we still have a lot of detail to do, so. I'm not even gonna worry about it yet. I'm just gonna leave it because I gotta do something else or I'll go crazy. Not really, I'm having fun, but it's kind of fun to say anyways. All right, let me grab our white and a touch of blue. Now, if I were to do that all day, I really might get tired of all the detail, but so that's the reason I'm gonna kind of bounce around, do some landscape, do some of the train, and do some landscape, and just keep bouncing back and forth there. So now I'm scrubbing on what seems like a little snow. We may have snow in the foreground, we may not. Not gonna worry about it either way. We know how to paint snow, it's pretty simple. There. I wonder if this is the way, you know, really detailed and tight artists feel when they paint landscapes. I wonder if they feel, you know, this. I bet it's that big of a difference. There. Because boy, when I go to do the tight stuff, it takes a little more concentration. There. Ah, that helps. That makes that look really nice back there. Let's do a little touch of snow on this guy here. This one's further away, so I want to just soften it a bit more. There we go. A little softness there. Good. All right. That's nice. Let's go ahead and change now to the 3/4 brush. And let me find something that doesn't have any of that clear gel in it. And let's work on our cliffs. Again, our light's coming from the right. There. We can also go ahead and add in cracks to the land here. Maybe this is rock or little ravines or something. It might be interesting. I'm just doing it with a basically brown and black. And there we go. I just think that's nice. Now, just kind of let you know what I'm thinking here. We're gonna do some smoke coming out, and that smoke is gonna come up and kind of billow out this way. So a lot of this area is gonna be covered. There, so, you know, kind of depends on how much you wanna work on it, but don't go crazy in this area, because your work will be wasted. There. Now, maybe over here, yeah, right about here, we could start to think about, just using this detail round, you could probably grab the little filbert, but hey, I got it in my hand, it's just one tree. There, I'm going to brush in a larger evergreen right here. There we go. Just like that, and then kind of let it stop. It's not a tall evergreen, it's a very short evergreen. It's one of those kind of stubby ones, the bushy ones. Kind of flare out at the top. Good. And we can obviously work on that one. It's just, I'm worried about more of the placement than anything else at this point, because I want to get my landscape in, then kind of fill the train in, get the tree, you know, fill it around the train, and then get the train in a little more detailed, and then kind of finish out things. And there, we may do snow, so I don't know how much of this color I want down here, but I'm just throwing color in at this point. There. Next, I'm going to go ahead and underpaint some grass. And yes, I know I'm starting with the light color. It's a little weird. Well, here's the thought, at least my thought behind all this, is I want this to be extremely bright here in the foreground. And sometimes you can just underpaint very lightly and then come back and even add more highlight. In this case, though, I think we're going to just grab a little brown. Look at my messy palette here. I'm going to grab a little brown, and I think I can just slide it in like this. This is actually a really easy way to make grass. And you can take your fan brush, which looks really dirty, and just lift up a little bit of fluffy grass so you can just touch it. This is a good way to get fluffy grass without a whole lot of paint on the canvas. There. I don't want a lot of texture next to my train, or really anywhere in this painting. I don't want a ton of texture because this isn't a highly texturized painting. If the train was really had no texture and then everything else had a lot of texture, yeah, might not look right. So I'm gonna be extra careful and just sort of keep things a little more flat than normal. Not flat, no depth, flat, no texture. So you can lift up and get plenty of depth, so there's no worries about that. Like, look over here, just stick some black, stick some yellow. I mean, we've done this before. There we go. I'm gonna smooth all this out so there's not that much texture. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and just throw on a little bit of highlight to some of these trees with our filbert brush. There, and I'm using a nice, kind of a golden yellow instead of a super bright green. I think it'll just make it seem more a little bit more like winter. Because I'd like to see some snow on the ground, actually. That would be fun. Not a lot, but, you know, just a little in the shade. Or maybe just some kind of laying in the, you know, where it would melt and kind of collect. Something, you know, something like that. There we go. So anyway, let's just throw some of these highlights on. This is a nice, simple way to get some good highlights pretty quick. And I'm done with that train for now. Probably for today. I think we need to just leave it and come back to it when it's dry. So I'm gonna go ahead and just complete our landscape, and then any final touches to the landscape we can do next time, but I think part two will be making that train look really nice. Lots of reflected light, lots of blue. Hopefully, I won't put much paint up here, so hopefully this will be dry, and we can even, I'll show you some dry brush blending, the smoke. I think it could be just really interesting. So let's go ahead and plan on a two-part video. I'll nearly never do this. I think we did that for, you know, that big painting. Remember that one? If you haven't seen it, go check it out. It was a lot of fun. That 4x8 foot painting. But other than that, we haven't really needed to, but this is such a different subject. I think it'd be well worthwhile. Plus, why bother rushing it? It's a lot of fun. All right, let me just finish up these trees here, and we'll go to something else. Now I want to just continue adding in some rocks over here. Maybe not quite so bright, actually. And this is great because it just helps our landscape kind of come together. And I'm using my 3/4 brush and really using kind of the side of it and using the big broad angles to create different, very sharp looking rocks, which is good. It's a quick way to do it, actually. Quick, nice way to do it. There, gotta make sure I say it's a quick, nice way because sometimes the quick ways are not always the great ways, but this is good. For rocks, this is really an effective, nice looking technique. So that's good. That helps to kind of add a little something right there. I'm just changing the shape of the rocks as I go. Yeah, that's good. Okay, because remember, we're going to bury this under more trees, maybe some snow. Who knows what we might throw up there. Let's go ahead and maybe just drop a little more light on. Started to put a little light, but let's do a little more. A little light right out on here, and this is going to make the train probably look a little less finished, but that's okay because we're going to kind of finish out the landscape, then finish out the train, so no worries. Now let's go ahead and fill this area in with some dark. And just like up there, it'll be rocks, but it'll look closer. There we go. I'm just going to do it quickly. And that way we won't have a lot of, you know, regular patterns or symmetry going on in these rocks, which would be kind of weird, don't you think? It'd be really weird. So anyway, kind of just a nice pile of rocks. We can do final touches next week, little grasses and things, but I want to get most of the landscape done today just so that we have tons of time and I don't feel like I'm rushed on that train. Which actually, now that we have all this in, the underpainting, the colors, the tones look pretty good. We just got to make it look realistic. We need to make it fit in the painting. I think we'll reflect the colors of the sky and the landscape around it, all that good stuff. I'm actually looking forward to it. Hopefully it'll dry. We'll see. I'm guessing within a week it'll be dry enough to at least sort of set my hand on it and do some stuff. Well, now I'm going to go ahead and just drop on our final highlight to this. Well, probably not even final, but at least a highlight to this rock area. Like before, I'll shape the rocks quickly, kind of jabbing at them, and just thinking about where I want the different shapes, but not necessarily planning it all out. There. Of course, we're going to need to stop, throw that one down, grab our dark again, and I'm going to clean up some areas that got too sloppy. There. So you can do that. And this is how I like to form our rocks. And I'll put some, you know, extra shadow and highlight next week if we need it. We'll see. There. Very nice. Good, good. It's just quiet in the kind of in the foreground, not really important to this particular painting. It's just kind of there. Maybe pull a couple of strokes to give the effect of maybe a little extra detail. Maybe we need a little more color. Yeah, that'll do it. Nice, okay, that's good. Roll a little extra color down on that side. Don't kill your darks, just sort of make it look 3D. All right, well, that's about all we're going to get done today. Now, I hope that most of this dries by next week, and then we'll go ahead and pick up where we left off in part 2. Also, don't forget to check out our website, TVDs and Brushline. Thanks for watching.